Hi there, I'm Karen Prince and I'm a writer. I'm quite surprised to find that a lot of you have not yet tapped into the awesomeness of Scrivener as your writing software. So I'm going to show you the top five reasons why I just love it. Scrivener is a powerful writing program with a lot of clever tricks, but don't be intimidated. Your writing life can change dramatically even if you only learn the few basic functions that suit you. First of all, Scrivener is really fast. Check it out. I can scroll up and down in this 100,000 word document without any lagging. You can see the size of the document in the word count bar at the bottom of the screen. The word count, incidentally, is live. It updates as you type. This is very handy for monitoring the progress of a scene, a chapter, or even your whole manuscript so far. Number two, with Scrivener, I can structure my projects the way I like them. I get an easily accessible tree of folders containing all of my reference material right beside my workspace. Number three, Scrivener has a Cork Board with index cards, which helps me to plot easily. I can drag the cards around, a bit like using a mind map. Number four, I can split my screen in two and work in one document with another open below it as a reference. Best of all, Scrivener can compile my manuscripts in epub or mobi formats for ebooks. This means I don't have to get a third party to convert my manuscript for me. To show you how fast Scrivener is, I'm going to shut down the program and reopen on an even bigger document. I don't have to bother with saving before I close. Scrivener saves constantly and automatically. This is in real time. I'm not fast forwarding it. And there you go. From launch to open document in seconds. Scrivener automatically opens up at the place I left off the last time I was working on this project. But if I didn't want to start here, Scrivener will search for the file I want instantly. If I go up into the search window and type in the name of the file that I want, in this case, I'll look for an image to describe. Scrivener will bring it up in the binder on the left-hand side of the main editor. Now I can click on the file icon to see my image file. I'll go back to the full manuscript to show you another find function. If I click inside the document, hold down Command and type F for find, another little window pops up. I can go in and change out a character's name here or correct every instance of a spelling mistake. Be careful of the replace all function. If the word you're replacing could be part of another word, you have to deal with each instance individually. Sometimes it's okay, but sometimes you risk this happening. Now I've got womanaged and womango. Now I'll show you how I like to structure my project for optimum convenience. The most important folder in a project is the manuscript folder. Any or all of the documents you put into it can be included in your document when you go to export. All of the folders on the outside of the manuscript folder are for your own information only and aren't included in your document when you export. So there is no danger of accidentally including a block of research in the middle of the manuscript you send to your agent. Within the manuscript folder, I have a folder for each chapter and then a document inside that folder for each scene. Scrivener will entitle your chapter whatever you have called the chapter file and assign it a number according to its descending order, like this. I don't call it chapter 1 yet in case I want to rearrange my chapter order. I can do this by dragging one chapter above the other in the binder. I I name my scenes anything really descriptive of what is in that scene, no matter how silly it looks, because Scrivener ignores the scene names. It just leaves a line break between scenes like this. Below the manuscript folder, I keep folders of every single thing I need for this project: character sketches, place descriptions and images, the politics and way of life of the tribes in my story, advice on plotting, style, revision, etc. I even have a folder containing all of the information I have gathered for each of the agents I am planning to query, their submission requirements, formatting preferences, and links to their blogs so that I can get to know if they are accepting work in my genre. I always start a project with characters. Of course, I have a plot in my head, but I have to know what kind of people all that stuff is going to happen to and how they would react. Scrivener provides you with template sheets, or you can make your own. I'll right-click on the template, drag it up to the characters folder, give it a name, and then go in and populate the template with anything I can think up about that character. Here are some character sketches I made earlier. I have a folder for each main character, with a character sketch, a couple of mugshots of people who remind me of that character, and any props associated with that character. This makes my life much easier in the drafting stages. For a whole group, in this case a tribe of Tokoloshes, I have a list of the characters mentioned by name, any distinguishing features or any situation that precludes that character from participating. Denby, in this case, can't be part of the search party because he is sleeping off the effects of a sugar overdose. Once I have used a description, I like to change the color of the text. That way I can avoid excessive eye rolling or telling my readers for the 100th time that the Tokolosh are knee high. Now while I'm writing, I can easily reference a character's file for a description, some inspiration, the color of his eyes or his dad's name, etc. But also, if I get into the groove while drafting and suddenly start adding props, mannerisms, terrible sunburn, I can pop these new ideas into the character files. I keep a similar checklist of all my character's powers, particularly the progression of those powers. If I move chapters around for dramatic effect, I don't want my protagonist using powers that he hasn't got yet. Now that I have some great characters, I move on to plotting, which brings me to the third reason I love Scrivener, and that is the Cork Board. It is capable of a lot more, but I mostly use it as a sort of brainstorming tool. I open up a folder for my plot, and then open up a document within that folder and name it anything that comes to mind. I then go up and select the Cork Board and add more documents with more ideas. Scrivener opens up a new document in the binder for every index card that I create. I can also double-click inside the index cards to write a short synopsis of each idea. Okay, but that's going to take too long. I'll open up my plot folder with the index cards already filled in. Now I can rearrange my plot ideas by dragging them around the cork board until I have the optimum outline of a plot. Notice that Scrivener updates the order of the documents in the binder as I move them on the cork board. Once my ideas are arranged in a nice flowing story, I can go up to the right-hand side of the main editor and open the inspector, which displays the synopsis on each index card. Now if I open up the document from the binder, I can flesh out my plot using that synopsis. Just to clarify, each index card with its synopsis is merely attached to its corresponding document in the binder. It isn't the actual document. When I've done that for all of my indexed cards, I end up with a full-on working synopsis of my plot. So I change the folder name to Working Synopsis. Now I'm going to show you the fourth reason I love Scrivener, and that is the split screen mode. I'll go over to the split screen icon in the toolbar at the top right-hand side of my work area and open up the split screen. The screen with the blue bar is the one that is active. If I open up a new document in the manuscript folder now, I can go ahead and write the scene using the synopsis below as a reference. I could also open up several research documents in the bottom screen and toggle between them as I write. Once I have written up a scene, I can select it in the synopsis folder and change the color of its icon. That way, I can see what progress I have made at a glance. Often when I'm editing, I will put a copy of the same scene into each of the two screens and rearrange paragraphs and sentences in one copy to see if I can improve on the flow of the story. Then I choose the best configuration and delete the other. While I'm on the subject of editing, just say I had a character that appears in three scenes and they are far apart in the story. If I hold down the Command key and select those three scenes, Scrivener will stack them one on top of the other in the main editor, and I can work on them together. This helps me keep the style and dialogue of a character consistent. And that brings me to the fifth reason I love Scrivener, which is the compile and export function. This saves money, but the best thing about it is having complete control over your document. When someone noticed a small typo in my book on Amazon Kindle, I was able to recall it, correct it, and have it back up on Amazon in a couple of hours. And that's not all. Scrivener gives you a lot of control over the output of the document itself. There are a lot of formatting options. I have played with the paperback novel and standard manuscript, which is the one that you send to your editor agent, but now I'm going to choose custom. You can include the entire manuscript or select only a couple of chapters without having to do any cutting and pasting in the actual document. Just check the boxes of the chapters you want in the include column. I'll select the first 5 or 6 chapters. Now I can compile it for print or as a PDF or rich text or even Microsoft Word if I want to send it to my editor for track changes. In this case, I'm going to choose mobi for Kindle. Then I'll go and add an internal cover and hit compile. It only takes a few seconds. There, done. Now I can preview it on my Kindle previewer. Free from Amazon, by the way. And that's what it will look like on the Kindle Fire. I like to backtrack on the previewer and check on my contents and my internal cover. I can also go up to the devices and open it up on the Kindle e-ink and check if my cover still has impact in black and white. I'll check if my contents page is properly interactive. There you go, it has jumped me straight to chapter 3. Now, if I'm not entirely happy with my product, I can go back into the compilation options in the compile function and make adjustments and test them until I'm satisfied. So that's it. My top 5 reasons why I write using Scrivener. So until next time, happy writing.